Clock in, clock in. Black Goddess walked in. Team, like, gotta stand up, man.
Yo.
Now, y'all, it's a lot of people who's really mad right now because of a video I just watched, y'all. And yes, I watched the video of the funny Marco video. Matter of fact, I watched the cool little 10 minutes of it. And I already seen from what I was watching what was really going on. And if you know, funny Marco be trolling everybody, bro. When I say he be trolling everybody, but I don't think he took it as far as G Herbo and Southside did. He don't be trolling them on that type time, but he just be really nonchalant. It just be real deal funny, bro. How he be asking random ass questions, them that exposing people. Shit be really funny, bro. But I guess Southside and G Herbo, they took it to themselves and was like, you know what, we finna troll his ass. And if y'all know, y'all know, man. I don't feel like watching through the whole thing, they purposely tried to disrespect Funny Marco, or they purposely tried to get him out of character. They probably did try to get him out of character, though. You never know, you feel what I'm saying? But I don't feel like they was doing it to be mean. I just feel like that's just how they play. Y'all ever seen somebody who mix white liquor with brown liquor? They act just like them on God. They act just like them. One of them boys was on that white, the other one was on that brown, and they were going crazy. You feel what I'm saying? But I'm really on here kind of confused because I ended up seeing Funny Marco write this post saying, I understand a lot of y'all mad about the interview. I was upset while it was going on, but I understand I got a job to do. And one thing about me, I respect people on my show. I didn't want to match their energy. It's so many L's I took on my journey. I wish I could show I don't hide anything. So I feel it was only right to put the episode out myself and just learn from the episode and move on. Thank who support me. It's a mindset thing. Now, when I seen that shit, I'm confused as hell because I'm thinking, okay, Funny Marco is staying in character. He not really mad. He just like, okay, these boys trying to be goofy as hell, so I ain't even finna trip. But after seeing him write that, I'm thinking to myself, like, was this nigga really sad? Was he really feeling some type of way that they was doing all this? Because now I'm confused because I don't know with Funny Marco. Because he could even be trolling with this damn message he wrote on his page. I don't know. I'm lost at this point. You feel me? If I was to say, did them boys take it too far during the video? Nah. But when I ended up hearing that they broke a damn watch.
Hey, shut the fuck up, dude.
All right,
let's get it. I'm giving you more respect than you deserve. So it's like, I'm coming. Oh, that's a piece of shit. Oh, God,
please. Yeah, at that moment, that's when I felt like them boys had one cup too many to drink. You feel me? Really out of pocket for that. And I heard they ended up giving the money back, but I could care less if the money was given back. My nigga, gonna break the damn watch, fam? He ain't even just throw it just to throw it so he could get a little scratch on it. I'm talking about he mega slammed that motherfucker and it broke to pieces. It just collapsed, bro. Now that's just beyond me. And I don't know what type of backlash Southside and G Herbo was expecting, but obviously they weren't expecting this. They was expecting probably the troller got trolled. You feel me? I didn't take it too strong because like them boys is just really drunk as hell, going too hard. You feel me? And while I'm thinking Marco in character, that nigga probably wasn't really in character. He really was probably kind of like, what the hell going on? And sort of intimidated. Boy, you better stop playing with G Herbo, baby mama. You too friendly with her. G Herbo probably really got smoked with you. And then he said something about his son don't even like your ass, boy. Come on now, stop playing. But let's see what Southside had to say.
Nobody that wasn't scared. Like, if you were scared, I can't help how your mama raised you. Like, what you like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't, that's why I stay off this shit, because no matter what it is, just make me the bad guy on this mob. When it come to, when it come to whatever, when it come to bitches, when it come to this, when it come to, you feel me? Like, whatever it come to, they make me the bad guy. Y'all just stop being pussy. Stop being pussy. Stop throwing rock in high y'all hands, bro. That go for rap. That go for comedians, that go for moguls, that go for whoever. I'm on his ass, bro. I don't want to hear that shit. I done let a lot of shit go. I done said, I just let go. Like, you know, I don't even get in the middle of shit no more. Like, and I'm still sitting here laughing right now. If you a bitch ass, just stay the fuck from around me. Like, I got enough bitches. I have a lot of, I deal with. I don't need no more bitches around me. You feel me? I'm cool. Bitch ass, just stay away from me, bro. That's it. You feel me? If you see me going somewhere and you know you out of me, don't speak. Don't fake kick it. Just leave me the fuck alone, bro. I'm cool. I don't gotta be nobody's friend. I'm rich, young, successful. I do music. I make beats. I'm not a rapper. I don't gotta mingle with you. I don't gotta do fucking interviews. I don't gotta do none of that shit. Paru, bro. Like, so for a nigga to get on there and say he's scared because they say he getting beat and all that other shit is like, you a you ain't have to put it out. Like, you know, now that he really want to or whatever it's called or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Or press you because you a grown man. I can't you. You a grown ass man. There's no way possible. Like, you know, for real. Herb wasn't even doing nothing. Herb wasn't doing nothing to that man. Like, you know, like, it is what it is. That's how them folks play. Like, it's cool for a nigga to get on there and say slick to niggas all day and do what they do. Like, you know what I'm saying? Or call a nigga for an interview and you don't know what kind of day a nigga having come do an interview and you would say some whole wig off the wall shit. It's like, come on, bro, don't do that. Like, don't DM me. Grown men, don't DM me. I'm not talking to, like, y'all stop DMing me. It's nothing for us to talk about. We ain't doing no music. Don't hit me. I don't have conversations with people. It's nobody. Like, that's just me. I'm not on. I don't even get on this. I just put this Instagram back on my phone just to say this to you. Like, leave me the fuck alone. Like, period, point blank and all. Leave me alone about. I don't want to hear about no business. What doing what? What doing what? I don't give a fuck. Because whatever y'all think it is, it's never that. You know what I'm saying? It's never, ever, 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 ever what y'all think it is. I swear to God. Like, you know what I'm saying? Ever, ever. And I fuck with Marco. Marco's still about. Marco just funny as shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? But I don't think he was uncomfortable. I think bro was good. Like, I think bro was all the way good, man.
I ain't gonna lie. That shit was confusing. And y'all, when I say confusing, I don't really be confused, bro. I just want you to think I'm confused. So when I do say something that makes sense, you be like, damn. But that nigga ain't confused. But apparently, Southside is confused. Matter of fact, he's more than confused. He had a lot to say about if Marco was scared. He don't know if he's scared for sure. And kind of blamed it on it's the way he raised or something. Like, it don't got nothing to do with how you raised, bro. Just because you're not going for what just happened don't mean you square, you soft, you cooch, whatever the case may be, bro. It don't got nothing to do with that, bro. You got to realize, bro, everybody ain't from the trenches. Everybody don't play the way you play, bro. He say G Herbo wasn't doing nothing. That nigga was doing a hell of a lot of talking, fam. You got to understand, bro, everybody ain't really your partner for you to play a certain type of way with them. Marco ain't expecting nobody to slap his hat, throw cups at him, break it down, watch, you feel what I'm saying? Talk to him any type of way. Bro, what, like, what the hell? Is D-Boy playing? Is they serious? Marco don't even know if y'all playing or if y'all serious. If y'all got something on y'all chest about him, do y'all? Y'all feel some type of way about the boy? You feel me? Marco confused as hell. He don't even know how y'all really feel about him to know, like, damn, is they joking or is they really trying to try me? Or is they really trying to troll me? You feel me? Southside say he don't think Marco feels some type of way. Southside, but you're a damn lie. But you know he feels some type of way if he had to go on the internet and write that. I understand if after the show, when the cameras went off, y'all dapped up and said, damn, bro, we were just playing with you. Apparently, y'all ain't do that. Apparently, y'all drunk ass probably just walked off laughing, hopping in the car. Yeah, we were fucking with fam, man. We played. Like, apparently, y'all thought he knew y'all was joking, but in his brain, he's thinking, like, do they really don't like me for real? Them boy really got some pressure with me or something. You feel what I'm saying? It's just a whole lot to it, man. But look, for the most part, y'all let me know how y'all feel about this video and all. Do y'all feel like they was playing a little bit too extra? Or do y'all feel like Marco need to toughen up, man? And understand when somebody come play with you, slap your hat, break your watch, and throw cups at you, you need to laugh it off. Let me know something. Catch y'all in that video, though. Shka!